55 through 41, please. Great to have you guys here, and congratulations for making this list. It's quite an honor. You've recorded many songs, some even with great hooks. What is it about Bye 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 that you think makes it the type of song to be on such a powerful list like this?
I think the fact that if you listen to it again, you know, you'll still like it. It's one of those songs you want to keep listening to over and over and over. And that's what always makes a good song for me. If I want to keep pushing, you know, rewind on the tape or, you know, skip back to hear it again on the CD, you just want to hear it over and over until you get tired of it.
Right. Well, good. Then watch this. You'll really get into it. Let's go ahead and watch this. Number 55 on the list, MTV and Rolling Stone. Bye 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 from NSYNC.
I don't know, I just love the way, I love that their music, their dance, their energy. To me, it's also pop music at its best.
I thought it was really, really cool because it was really, it's a little bit more R&B, a little more hip-hop than what they're normally doing. More in your face, I thought it was hot. I thought it was really cool and the vocals sounded good. Baby, bye, 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 bye.
They cross further over into the hip-hop and rock world than other boy bands do, who really kind of stay into the pop world. And I think with bringing those other genres in, they just funk out their sound and they get a broader audience as a result.
It's got a little more edge to it. It's got a little more urban flavor to it. We're not totally hip-hop or totally R&B. You know, there's a pop flavor to what we do. And it's one of those songs that it's got that hook and you hear it once and you hear it for like the next 2 days in your head. Baby, bye, bye, bye.
All their music is built around dance. That move they did became like the theme of that whole song.
I think that they can dance their butts off and sing their butts off. I mean, their show is incredible. The production is incredible.
They put on a great show. They use fireworks, they use TV screens, and they use their arms and legs.
NSYNC, that was their contribution to the list. Bye 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 at 55. We saw some of that footage from that phenomenal performance. 2003 Music Awards. That was very cool.
Thank you.
Which rehearsal time did that take?
Working with the TVs, we had about 2 days to do it, but about 4 days to rework the whole dance and put the medley together. And originally it was like going to be about 4 hours long, but they cut us down to three and a half minutes.
Right, yeah. They had a little show to do. In the 80s, this next punk funk band often performed naked. By the early 90s, it was their Naked Emotion of our number 54 song that made the Red Hot Chili Peppers the emperors of pop. I know I'm a huge fan. JC, what do you think?
They're creative, you know what I mean? They come out with something different every time. They wear the craziest costumes, if they wear them at all.
We didn't see ever get on stage with just socks.
On my ears.
Maybe like hey, sleeping bags.
Have you
or
ever
something.
Been home alone and honestly just tried that?
The sock
no.
thing?
Yeah. The Did Chili you? Peppers inspired me to try that.
No,
I swear
actually,
to God.
Actually, I must confess, there was this one time in band camp.
Oh, stop. Stop. All right, so let's go ahead and watch the Red Hot Chili Peppers here. Chili Peppers Under the Bridge at number 50. For Michael, who recently just spent more than $2 million to buy John Lennon's piano at an auction. The same piano he composed Imagine on. It's pretty weird. I mean, we could auction this seat off once Justin gets off it for God knows how much money. Does that freak you guys out a little bit? Everywhere you go and the things that you touch, I mean, that it's that fanatic and the...
It's a little weird.
French toast.
Yeah, French toast.
Yeah, what was that whole story? That was here in New York, wasn't it?
Yes, it was.
Z100 did that. Yeah,
like after you walked out, there's the plate and they put on eBay and it...
The only thing good that came out of that was that it went to charity.
All right, Justin, take us out of here.
All right,
take a break.
Don't move, because when the show continues, we'll hear from Blink-182, Elton John, Destiny's Child, 98 Degrees, Lenny Kravitz, U2, and the ultimate pop legend, Paul McCartney himself. Stay tuned.
I'm Carson Daly, back with NSYNC. We're counting down the 100 greatest pop songs of the last four decades.
Beatles. Chris, I know you're a huge Beatles fan. How have they maybe influenced this group?
I grew up in the 80s with just listening to the Beatles. I didn't even listen to any 80s pop or 80s music. It was all the Beatles because my mom, you know, pushed the Beatles on me and said, this is talent. This is what you need to listen to. This is what you need to do. So I started listening to them, and they're a big influence on me and actually all of us.
And sometimes they set the standard that it's okay to change. It's okay.
Exactly.
We can take our music here. We can change our image a little bit.
What was great was they evolved with their fans. You know, they started out with, you know,
screaming
a young
teenagers.
Fan base, and then it just grew and grew until, like, today, you know, everyone is a fan. So that would be nice.
Absolutely. The 100 Greatest Pop Songs of the Countdown will conclude, by the way, with a two-hour Top 40 Bash, which will feature my special guest, the Backstreet Boys, and Sir Paul McCartney. And here's a sneak peek of the time I spent with the legendary ex-Beatle, sharing his thoughts on our number 52 song, his own, Maybe I'm Amazed. Number 52, and you'll see more of me and Paul McCartney hanging out in the big Top 40 show, which is awesome. Be sure and catch that. Joey, I know you're a fan of The Temptations.
Oh, yes,
tell me about your Temptation days, and what is it about The Temptations?
I grew up listening to Temptations, Frankie Lyman Teenagers, all that kind of stuff. One of the first things when I saw a lot of them, when they used to dance and sing with the mics and everything, kind of like they had a real smooth, cool kind of choreography. And just their harmonies. It was just a good time in the 50s because a lot of doo-wop, you know, singers and stuff were in. So it was,
ooh, say, what?
From all that. Is there a Temptations cover coming from NSYNC ever? We just started 3 seconds of it, and that was it. Joe, you want the honors once we can check out
sure.
The Temptations?
Temptations, great choreography, great harmonies, and a great song, Just My Imagination.
But it was just my imagination.
The flow of that song is so beautiful. The way all the music with the vocals is just so pretty.
Temptations were a huge inspiration on us. I think every vocal group did the same thing. They kind of started the whole dancing vocal thing.
Every hand was synchronized. Every foot, every little step was all together.
Just my imagination running away.
That brought back some memories, that particular video and song
memories.
And memories. Chris, you're a big Prince fan. I'm glad I can call him Prince again.
We're all Prince fans. Yeah.
Everybody's a fan.
I was really getting annoying going, yeah, we're fans of that guy.
Somebody, I guess, who did some early blending of like R&B and rock.
Yeah.
How do you think he did that?
He's the man.
He's a man that can sing high and sound and look cool.
And low.
Right.
And still look cool.
He can wear tights and look cool.
And he started that whole,
he can wear buns.
Cheek out.
Yeah.
He started that.
Buns to the wind.
You can take us out to breaker?
Sure. Up next, we'll hear from Blink 182, Foo Fighters, U2, Lenny Kravitz, and 98 Degrees. Plus, Puffy talks about the song that makes him want to run home and kiss his girlfriend. Stay tuned.
Carson Daly here with NSYNC, Countdown, the 100 Greatest Pop Songs of the last 4 decades, as chosen by MTV and Rolling Stone magazine. You can all check it out at the new issue.
And he's got it.
Thank you very much.
Tell him what they get, Benna.
Rolling Stone magazine. You get this nice commemorative collector's item edition. The Countdown, by the way, has a timeline of basically the British invasion to the boy bands. I'm so sick of saying that whole phrase. I mean, isn't it time to lose? You guys got to be just incredibly sick of it, you know?
Most of us are in our 20s. Are we still boys or young men?
I don't understand
it. Well, first of all, we're not a band. We're a vocal thing.
Yeah.
We're a vocal thing.
We're a boy vocal thing?
Yeah.
Was there a definitive point maybe in like the last, I don't know, 16 months where just that phrase just really got to every one of you?
It's been more than 16 months. It started over in Europe.
Yeah,
they started calling us that. And we were like, what the heck is that? And the next thing we know, we were thrown in with a bunch of garbage. And
I think boy band, like, it was used to represent a group that was, like, put together by a record company that really can't sing,
right.
You know, lip syncing. And that's like a lot of European groups.
Okay, but then you put out a record called No Strings Attached. Everybody knows about all the trouble you guys went through. You couldn't be more clear about the fact that we are in control. And they still
are
putting on to a phrase. I think I'm going to make it my job in the new year to come up with, like, a new term that is respectful and suitable for everybody.
Thank you.
Maybe we'll
Thanks,
do that
Carson.
During
do that.
This particular...
I'm going to vote for
and
you.
And you're just the man to do it.
Yeah, that's right. All right? It's all the new issue here. At number 49 is a folk song with storytelling so vivid it reminds White Club John of hip-hop. Take
Tangled Up in Blue is number 49 on our list. I'm here with NSYNC. Before we move on, I was talking to Jennifer Lopez about this very thing. I think that we should have kept the word to popular, not pop. I think pop's gotten a bad thing because it's pop and it's poppy and it's air and it's fluffy and it doesn't last long. But the word popular, the most amount of people that want to hear your music, therefore making you popular, is an incredible achievement. But to be a part or associated with pop, people have a problem with that.
Like you are so deep.
I'm not embarrassed to be a pop artist. I mean, there's a ton of them out there. For that matter, you too called an album pop. And, I mean, Madonna's in that category. Michael Jackson's in that category. People like that. Some of the hugest icons, some of the most respected artists out there still today, legends, are put in that pop category, and I don't mind it a bit.
And Joey, what makes a good pop song?
I don't know. It's just you can hear it over and over again. I guess the hooks. So the hooks are really
I also got to say that it's got to be something that people can relate to, whether it be just a happy song that people want to go out and dance to, or whether it be the message in the song.
Like Umbop, it's always, I don't relate to.
But I recognize it to be a great pop song.
It's a great hook.
It's a great pop song.
But the thing is, doesn't necessarily
you relate to it in a way, you get those thoughts in your head where you just don't care about anything, and that's basically what it is. It's a carefree song, you know what I mean? Somehow, in some way, shape, or form, you have to be able to relate to the song, whether it be to the groove or the lyrics. Right. You know, there's got to be some sort of relationship for it.
Making it, therefore, popular. We have a pop song now, I guess. Pearl Jam is on our countdown with what may be their best-known song, thanks to a haunting topic and just an unbelievable voice from Eddie Vedder. And an all-too-familiar beginning note. Here's Jeremy at 48. Jump at number 47. Here with NSYNC. Anybody have any Jump memories? All I know is that the first note of that song, you know what it is.
Yeah.
It's one of those songs.
I think
songs.
Everybody, that's like one of the first songs anybody learns how to play on the keyboard.
Right.
It was actually one of my first like videos that I actually really saw on MTV.
Yeah.
I didn't have cable in New York when I came.
Well, there was only Florida.
I know, when I came to Florida on vacation, it was there. I was like, wow, cool.
Right. And then like Rio, Duran Duran would come on. Like, all right, it's MTV. All right, Justin, take us out. We got to take a quick break here.
All right, so we'll be back to count down more of the 100 greatest with some memories from Lenny Kravitz, Puffy, the sexy actress Kate Hudson, and 98 Degrees. Keep it here.
Hi, we're NSYNC here with Carson Daly counting down MTV and Rolling Stone's 100 greatest pop songs of the last four decades.
And next on the list, back in 1965, America began its love affair with a lava lamp. Anybody ever have a lava lamp?
Oh yeah, I've never had a lava affair with a lava lamp.
I remember the first time I looked at it, I'd be like, you know how expensive lava lamps are?
They get hot. JC broke my lava lamp.
Yeah, I actually did. I smashed it.
Hard to get out of the rug, let me tell you.
Yeah, all right, that's a whole other story. well, obviously, none of your fans were probably born yet around this time. It was the year of Smokey and the Miracles, and they hit the charts.
I wasn't even alive.
No, you weren't. With our number 46 song.
He influenced artists because he's a great writer, he's a great singer, and he's pretty. You know, the cat had it all. And I know I was influenced. I wrote It Ain't Over Till It's Over because I wanted it to sound like Smokey Robinson. So take a good look at my face.
You'll see my smile looks out of place. Smokey had the face of an angel and the voice of an angel. Had an unbelievably beautiful falsetto. There are guys out there who do it today. D'Angelo, he's one of them. Justin from NSYNC, sometimes when he's lucky and he's thinking about Britney really hard, then he can hit these kinds of beautiful, soulful notes. Smokey, though, my God, he's just the greatest. Although she may be cute, she's just a substitute. Because you're the
permanent one. Eric Clapton's Tears in Heaven. That's Dancing Queen from ABBA, number 44. When the countdown continues, 98 Degrees, Puffy, Elton John, actress Kate Hudson. Foo Fighters get their 2 cents in. Plus, is it a love song? Or is it a stalker song? We'll let you know when we get back. We'll be right back with more of NSYNC.
And Kate Hudson.
I think song's 100 greatest pop songs countdown. In Carson Daly here with the guys in NSYNC. And we're up to number 43. And I did see a picture of, this is a bizarre picture, of NSYNC and Keith Richards of the Rolling Stones. What did he possibly say to you, and did you understand what he was saying to you?
I think he was lost when he came to the show. He just kind of staggered in and figured out that
Which way
to the stage?
That was great. It was a surprise. You know, he liked our music, so he wanted to come see the show. And he really enjoyed it. And It was really cool because we always played the Stones right before our show.
Our sound guy, Tim Miller, is a huge Stones fan, so he, it's tradition that we hear the Stones.
All right, very cool. Want to go ahead and get us into the Stones here,
Lance? Sure. At number 43, five guys who once called themselves the greatest rock and roll band in the world take a stab at disco sound. Here's the Rolling Stones with Miss You.
Rolling Stones.
For me, was like my first crush, Tattoo You, the album, Tops, and Miss You.
I've been hanging out so long, I've been sleeping all alone, Lord, I miss you.
I love that song, Miss You. I think it's a bitchin' pop song.
Disco tune.
It's a disco tune, though, you know, but it's a good one.
Rolling Stones are another band that have been around for a million years because they can sort of grab elements of what's going on at that moment in music and pull it into their sound. And Miss You was actually kind of a stab at disco. It sounds very much like what you would hear at a club in the late 1970s, early 1980s, and yet they make it their sound.
Rolling Stones, Miss You at number 40.
The Police, Every Breath You Take. That song was another smash of all time. Sting's awesome.
He's an amazing songwriter. He's written some very, very incredible songs. Every breath you take.
It's a haunting song, Every Breath You Take. You sort of see the band at its best in many ways.
There is a weird, dark undercurrent that doesn't play out that obviously in the music. And that's one of the interesting things about pop songs is they can sound one way and mean something else. Certainly a song about romantic obsession. The key to it is the, you know, I'll be watching you.
In the summer of 1997, Puffy Combs gave this Police classic a whole new meaning to a whole new generation after the death of his friend, the notorious B.I.G.
I wanted to do a song in his honor, a tribute song to him, and one day I was watching MTV, as a matter of fact, and the Every Breath You Take video was on, but I really connected with the song.
I was deeply touched that he chose to remember his friend with my song, you know, because the song has a lot of emotional content for me, and it obviously meant something to him.
Check it.
I felt that, you know, Biggie was like talking to me through the song, that he'll be there every move I make.
It's kind of hard with you not around, know you in heaven smiling down, watching us while we pray for you.
Even though I know when the Police did it, it had a different meaning. Every time you hear a song, you take, you let it, you apply it to what's going on in your life.
Clap your hands for Notorious B.I.G. Clap your hands for everybody we lost. We miss you.
CCR is proud Mary at number 41. It's a thunderous applaud for CCR. I think JC and I had similar childhood memories of CCR, just real quick before we move on or close the show. My father was a huge fan. I have memories of coming home from like school and like Little League hearing that.
We'd come home from my dad's
voice.
Softball games every weekend, and CCR's, you know, in the tape deck, man. And
did that drive you to enjoy it or to hate it?
I loved it. I love listening to the oldie stations and stuff like that. I like, you know, the Moody Blues and stuff like that. All these different kind of rock bands from back then. So.
Yeah, and that signature voice, which is so familiar.
Fogerty.
I guess that's what pop does. Puts you right back to where you were. That's going to conclude this portion of the program. Be sure and join us for the big finale, the two-hour Top 40 Blowout with my special guest, the Backstreet Boys, and former Beatles Paul McCartney. There's a two-hour special. We're going to have songs by Britney, Madonna, GNR, U2, appearances from Fred Durst, Jennifer Lopez, Destiny's Child, Lil' Kim, Spice Girls, Lenny Kravitz, and so much more. I want to thank the audience for hanging out, and our special thanks to NSYNC for joining us. I'm Carson Daly, and we'll see you around. Later.